Hello, welcome to another video by Indicator Vault. In this video, I'm actually going to go over this trade setup that could have been taken in this most recent week. As you can see, I've got the British pound and the Australian dollar, the 4-hour chart. And so we're going to go over, you know, how we could have caught, you know, up here, you know, the top of this candle. And you can see a significant move down, you know, not quite taking out this low yet, but getting in up here with a stop above here, as I'll show you, obviously incredible risk to reward ratio that was available. And I'm going to use it or do this video using the Supply Demand Pro, and then a little bit in a lower time frame. Bring on the Divergence Dashboard as far as another or an extra confirmation to go short. So here we are on the 4-hour chart, and we can see with this wick forms a supply zone with the Supply Demand Pro and comes back into it. So our bias on this time frame is to have price respect this zone and continue short. So this is our higher time frame bias. You know, obviously you can go to the daily and weekly as well, but just for this example, we're going to start on the 4-hour and work our way down. Now let me hide this real quick and kind of give a little tip of how I view some wicks like these. For instance, when there's a relatively large wick and it takes out a previous high, and then also that candle closes below the high that it just recently took, I like to look at the 50% mark of that wick. So I'm going to mark that here. You see, I just drew a fib from the high to the close of this candle, and that is the halfway point of that wick. So that will act as kind of like a gap, and you will very many times see certain POIs or smaller time frame gaps here. It's just going to act as a, you know, sensitive price level. Of course, we can see price does wick above it a little bit and then continuing down. So again, price retraces back into the supply zone. We do see, not much, but we do see a small break of structure here as the candles close below it before it retraces. So even here, as we have the break of structure with the supply zone above, we can expect some more bearishness up here. So let me hide this for now, and we'll go into the 1-hour time frame, and this is where I want to show you the other confirmation with the Divergence Dashboard. So we can see here on the 1-hour now, it has shown bearish divergence between this high and this high. So with these confirmations so far, just on the 4-hour and the 1-hour, we can easily expect this high to hold because of the break of structure on the 4-hour and the 1-hour, the supply zone it's now come into, and the divergence basically telling us this high should hold price and it should be respected. And of course, obviously, in hindsight, we can see that it has. But that's just an extra confirmation I wanted to point out. And, you know, you don't have to just rely on one indicator, and you shouldn't. You need multiple confluences, and that's something you can add in, you know, to your trade plan. You know, if you just wanted to get your directional bias from one or two indicators on the higher time frame, you know, for instance, we're looking for a sell. We know it's in a supply zone. So we're not going to confuse ourselves switching back and forth. You know, until price tells us something different, we're looking for sells inside the supply zone. So then you can drop to your lower time frames and, you know, also add some extra confirmations. You know, look for some divergences. It doesn't necessarily have to just be on the 1 hour or one time frame below. You know, you can look for it on multiple time frames or have maybe just one or two specific ones that you want to look at. Maybe you want to have at least two time frames are showing the same divergence before getting in a trade. I'm just trying to show some examples of how to use these indicators together. But let's drop down to a 15 minute. And I'm going to use the replay bar here, actually. So again, this is where we're at. Remember, this yellow line is the halfway point of that 4 hour wick. So we're expecting price to be sensitive here. And even though we do have the break of structure, you should always expect some kind of retracement. And so then it's realizing what areas it should retrace to. So let's start here for the replay. We'll turn on the supply demand pro again. And again, for some of these, we're looking more for just supply to hold because we're not getting in buys, right? We're not taking lower time frame buys when price is now going into a higher time frame supply zone, right? See, a supply zone is formed up here. Now we're expecting a retracement. And you're going to see price just fall short of it. However, it has already reached the main, as far as exact price level that we're, you know, looking for price to react from. It has already reached it. And so we can start looking for shorts here. So again, I wanted to point this out that it didn't reach this supply, but that's okay because it has already reached our price level we are interested in it reaching. And then we can also pair that, couple that logic with we are expecting this high to hold because of the divergence. The 1 hour divergence is showing us this high should hold, and it has already reached our main price level. So here we can start looking for shorts. And this is the 15 minute. Let me go to the 5 minute now. We can see supply demand zone, it's still on the replay. Hasn't reached here, but I want to show you here. It's reached our zone. Right there. So, again, just to reiterate, I know this supply zone is up here, but it's already reached our level that we can look for shorts from now. So it reaches it, and now on the lower time frame, the 5 minute, it's created a lower supply zone. Goes down, retraces right back into it. So let me actually move this line to where our entry would have been. You could put it right at the bottom of the 5 minute supply zone. And if you want to have an aggressive stop, let me hide this, you could just put your stop above this high. But again, the more conservative one, would be above this one. This is the one we are expecting to hold. But look at the price sensitivity to the bottom of that supply zone. Never comes back to it at all. Never closes above it, just wicks above it once and then continues to fall down. So I'm going to just there we go. So let me actually jump back to the 1 hour. Okay, and I want to put this short position on just to show what could have been possible using this logic as far as risk to reward. Drag that over with stop above there, looking at about a 32 pip stop with the more conservative one. Believing that high would not get broken, which it doesn't. Again, our entry was at that yellow line. And if we're bearish, we can expect what? A new lower low to be formed. So again, your entry's here. And so we're not taking this account or this low into account. It's the lows before the entry, which would be here. Over 140 pips, 145 with a risk to reward of 4.5. That is a great trade to take in a week. If you took the super aggressive entry with your stop above that one, you now have an insane almost 13R, 12.7R right there. Of course, it does go even lower and it may even take out these lows, but that's just as far as the main logic of a bearish trade to create the new lower low. We have it for here. Of course, you can take partials along the way, and you know, who knows, maybe the following weeks it'll start taking out these lows as well. But anyway, I wanted to create this video just to show some examples with the indicator vault indicators, and just, you know, the supply demand pro in the divergence dashboard I had on here, just for some simple confirmations and price action concepts to get into this trade. I hope this video was helpful, and until next time, best of luck trading.